Hi, I'm Rick Vanover from Veeam. Backup and recovery of Hyper-V environments doesn't have to be difficult. I know a lot of people are familiar with other hypervisor support that we may have here at Veeam, but make no mistake, we have a really strong Hyper-V support offering in the Veeam Data Platform. And speaking of which, if you haven't seen some of our other videos on the YouTube channel, check them out. Make sure you're subscribing because we're always working on new demos. And if you want to see something, let us know in the comments and we'll see if we can get it on the production schedule. But enough about that. If you want to know more about Hyper-V, let me show you just how easy it is to do that. Let's jump into the lab. All right, so what I'm looking at is the Veeam Backup and Replication console. And if you've not been into the backup infrastructure section, that's an important area where you add the source systems that you will be backing up. So let's take a look at the Hyper-V wizard before I go into the specifics of how it works. You can add a specific Hyper-V server just like I have here, and there's two already in there. But if you go up here and add a server, you have this nice wizard that'll add your VMware hypervisors, your Hyper-V hypervisors, as well as some other different offerings from Veeam. But let's talk about the Hyper-V option. Now, the Hyper-V support can go a number of different ways. I like to say that there's full Hyper-V support, whether you're doing SMB3 shares with the Hyper-V VMs, as well as the traditional Hyper-V options of standalone hosts, Hyper-V failover clusters, as well as System Center virtual machine managed resources. And when you do that, you just then go to that same wizard that I just have shown. And a lot of times it'll figure it out with what you have configured. So I have an environment here with two different Hyper-V hosts in play. Now what you can do is really simply backup and recover just like you would with any other hypervisor. So let me walk you through a job here. I've made a backup job, I've given it a name, example 16 Hyper-V VMs, created by me. And you have a lot of options for what you are backing up. So I am inventorying the job by the host. So this is actually an interesting technique because anything that's added will automatically be protected. So if you had a System Center VMM deployment with some tags and stuff like that, you can also build it that way. You can look by data stores, you can look by individual VMs. You have a lot of flexibility. But for this environment, by going with both hosts, no matter what is where, I will have them all protected. Another thing to note is you have the ability to back up one of two ways from a proxy standpoint. So this notion of an off-host backup is basically the backup is done off of the host, and you have the ability to have an on-host proxy as well. You can configure this right here. Now, if you have a cluster, you know, you might want to have the on-host option, but you have full control over how you shape your traffic for a Hyper-V backup. Now, like all other Veeam backups, they go to a backup repository. That's simply basically any storage resource from a purpose-built deduplication appliance to the cloud to even NAS shares or object storage. You can put Veeam backups nearly anywhere. I'm putting them on the scale-out backup repository, which is sitting alongside the other different resources I have. This particular one is using immutability twice, once on-premises, once off-site. I could also go into the Veeam Harden repository, which is a free way on Linux to have immutable backups. You have a lot of different ways to do this. By default, backup jobs will go for 7 days. Now, it's up to you to really think about how much you want to keep, especially with immutability. Now, I have one safeguard in place here because my scale-out backup repository has a capacity tier, so I immediately am adhering to the 3-2-1 rule, as one copy is automatically sent off-site. Be sure to check out my video about object storage, where I walk through the scale-out backup repository, and you can see how that works as well. You also can make it run by restore points. So for example, that 7, if I make it, let's go with 28. If I say 28 restore points, but I run this job, say, every 6 hours, that still would be 1 week of retention, but it would go every 4 hours. So If you think about the restore points, and it's basically a mathematical extension from what happens over here on the schedule option, you have a lot of flexibility as a short takeaway. Additionally, if you want to have GFS retention, which stands for grandfather, father, son, you could say, I want additional retention, full backups to be kept as well. So let's say, for example, I want to keep 4 weeks and then 12 months. Like this could be a full year of retention with independent full backups as well as for the month. If I'm running every 6 hours, I'll keep a very precise amount of recovery options. So this is a really attractive RTO and RPO by having also the long retention through basically a year. And both copies are immutable. Pretty attractive. I can do guest application processing. So for example, I can get into the business of saying, hey, if there's a SQL database, I want it handled a certain way, as well as Oracle, Postgres, etc. I don't have any SQL databases here, but it has some automatic handling, which is attractive. I also can do a guest file system index. Highly encourage this. If you're looking for a file, we have an index of those files that makes it easy to do those recoveries. Now, to do those indexing and those application-aware processing tasks, it's a good idea to have an account inventory. So I'll put one in. And then what's also nice is you can test those credentials as well and specify individual credentials for different systems. Really important if you're mixing Windows and Linux. So if you get into this, you could get into saying, hey, that one's Linux, let me set a different user. And the other thing you can get into doing is also this schedule. So I said I changed it from 7 to 28. So if I would go periodically every 6 hours. So that's that mathematical extension that I just mentioned. Now, one thing that's really important about a backup window, maybe you don't want it done during the business hours, or if you have a very specific part of the business day or the week that is not a good candidate for backups, you could do something like this. Now, basically what'll happen is it'll still try to run every 6 hours, but not through that identified zone right there. So you have full control over when this will happen. The other option you could do is run it after another job happens, right? But I'll just leave this 6 hour example in here. So just like that, I've created this backup job and I've got a nice amount of retention. And when it comes to recovery, if I go over here and look at what's on disk, I put it on object storage, so let me double check that here. You'll see that these Hyper-V VMs, and actually what's really cool I could highlight right here is you can see just by the different ones that this is a Hyper-V VM and that this is a virtual machine that's on VMware. So there's some little icons that help you kind of self-indicate what is what. And then I have a lot of options. So I can take this Hyper-V virtual machine backup and I could instantly recover it back to the hypervisor it came from, or I could change it over to another hypervisor. Or maybe today is the day I go to the cloud. I can transparently recover these to the cloud as well. So many different recovery options for Hyper-V. And likewise, these virtual machines up here that are VMware backups, they can be instantly converted over to Hyper-V. So this is a really powerful way that you can have high-speed recovery, high-speed backups as well with Hyper-V. In fact, this is a small environment, but the incremental backups go really, really quick. So as I've shown you, doing backups in Hyper-V with Veeam Backup and Replication, which is part of the Veeam Data Platform, is really easy. And you have a lot of flexibility on where the backups go, what retention you have, immutability everywhere, and then also if you need to convert to another hypervisor to or from or to the cloud, you have so many options with Veeam. I really encourage you to download a trial, play with this on your own, see how it can help you keep your Hyper-V environments protected and have all kinds of recovery options. Thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next video.